दैट इक्वेशन आई विल टेक एज बर्नौली इक्वेशन एंड देन कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन. सो फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन वॉट इज कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन. सो वेन एवर वी टॉक अबाउट कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन, स्टूडेंट सेज क्विकली, दे से दैट सर एम डॉट इज इक्वल टू रो ए वी, दिस इज अवर कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन. बट वॉट इज द फिजिकल फील्ड बिहाइंड दिस इक्वेशन दैट विल अंडरस्टैंड. सपोज यू हैव एनी रैंडम शेप डक्ट, ओनली वन थिंग इज क्लियर, वेयर इज योर इनपुट एंड वेयर इज योर आउटपुट. सो फ्रॉम दिस इनलेट सम फ्लूड विल एंटर एंड फ्रॉम दिस आउटलेट दैट फ्लूड विल कम आउट. नाउ इमेजिन दिस ट्यूब इज समथिंग मैजिकल एंड इफ एम इज इक्वल टू 1 kg is entering every second, but from here m is equal to 3 kg is coming out every second. Imagine this situation, that from here you are giving only 1 kg per second, but how much is coming out? 3 kg per second is coming out. So mass is increasing at the inlet, m2 is greater than m1. So this is not a continuity case, but situation is how the mass is increasing at the inlet, at the outlet. It means definitely in between somewhere mass is being produced. So mass can produce if and only if some kind of nuclear reaction is happening. So in our gas dynamics we don't have to consider that kind of nuclear reactions. We only have to consider our basic propulsion. So in that case, whatever mass will enter into the system, same amount of mass will come out of the system. Now, based on this physical field, we design nozzle and diffuser. These two are ducts, nozzle and diffuser. What is the role of nozzle? What is the role of diffuser? They work on this concept, equation of continuity. Let's understand. So first I take diffuser and then I take nozzle. Diffuser can be any device of any shape, but what is the work? Work is it has to decrease the velocity of the coming liquid, coming fluid. So suppose whatever the shape, let me take pen, whatever the shape is, sometimes when I say diffuser people think like this, nozzle people think like this. No. Whatever is the shape, if the inlet liquid, speed of the inlet liquid is everyone is available, but Teerthraj is not available. I can see everyone, I can't see Teerthraj. I got Teerthraj now. Okay, I can see now. So I will start that. See guys, I am trying to explain that continuity equation. See, why should we understand everything in this way? Because in GATE exam, they can ask any type of question. They don't have a common set like, okay, only in this way they will ask the question. So your job is clear the concept, whatever depth it is. Clear everything. And clearing concept is not a big deal. We need only 3 things in our life to achieve the 4 things. MMM. One is mood to study. One is master to study, one is material to study. And if you have all the right thing with you, right mood, right master, right material, then you will be having this fourth M you can say as a marks in your exam, or you can say money in future. Okay, so guys, continuity question. Consider you have any duct, and it can look like anything. It can look like this also, anything, any random shape, whatever blender shape you can imagine. But something is entering with certain speed, 10 meter per second. Suppose the liquid or the fluid, but it is coming out with 6 meter per second. Then we say this as diffuser. Simple. Same way, if something is coming here with 10, but going out as some 15, more than 10, then this is known as nozzle. Okay. In our subjects, we have two categories of the motion. First, one motion we keep as subsonic, and one which is not subsonic. So if something is not subsonic, then it can be supersonic or hypersonic or sonic, something. So we focus on subsonic. In case of subsonic, if you want to decrease the speed of the coming thing, suppose whatever area is here, that area is 10 meter square, that you say as A1, and whatever area is here, that is also 10 meter square, you say A2, and some liquid is entering into this, and you have to consider subsonic or supersonic. Currently I am taking subsonic example. Fluid is entering with certain velocity, 20 meter per second. Then this velocity, when it will come this side, it should decrease. It should be some 50 meter per second, 15 meter per second, or some 12 or something, less than 20. So to decrease this speed, suppose this science you are developing first time in your life. We are the first scientist developing diffuser in our life, and we will introduce the diffuser to the world. Then what we have to do? See, currently everyone knows that, okay, this is the shape of diffuser. But how will you get this idea that this is the shape of diffuser? So understand that. There only the name comes, continuity. So imagine this shape. Means you are taking this point this side, you are taking this point this side. So this is coming like this. So your new shape became like this. So what, suppose here some 4 molecules are entering at a time. So when they will go out, they have to maintain 4 molecules. They can't produce 5 molecules because we are not considering nuclear reaction. They can't be 5 molecules. They will be only 4 molecules because only 4 molecules are entering. So only 4 molecules should come out. Now what is the question here? Question is, if they will enter here with 20 meter per second, what makes them to come out with less than 20? Some 15 meter per second. What makes them? So see, idea is, if they will go in a straight way like this, then definitely they all are traveling same distance in same time. So at the end, they will be having same speed also. Means 20 means 20 here also. But because you have given them enough space, and because they are molecules, and molecules have nature to expand, so this guy will go in this direction, so length increased, so it will take more time. So here, like this, length is increased. So means what? Then they will decide to go in this direction also, and it is nature that if you give the space, you can't control that. It's a nature. What kind of nature I'm saying? Suppose this is the room, and you take any body deodorant, perfume, something. You open that perfume here, then that perfume will it will spread out in entire room. That is the nature, we can't control that. That's why I'm saying these all molecules will spread together. So in spreading that, they will lose some energy. What kind of energy? Kinetic energy. So when they will come out, they will be having less velocity. They will be having less speed. But at the same time, when you will make this kind of design, then what will happen? They are 4 molecules. Because main thing is, whatever mass is entering, same amount of mass has to come out also. So that's why they will expand properly. But in this case, what is happening? We are contracting them. we are reducing their size and shape. So what will happen? This guy will go in this direction. This guy will go in this direction. This guy will go in this. So they will be having, you can see, they will be having less gap. So they can't touch each other. Because yesterday I taught you, molecules can't maintain a distance lower than critical distance. So they can't be very, very closer to each other. So then what will they do? They will quickly flush out. Because they can't touch each other. So they will quickly flush out. So that's why in nozzle, speed will increase. So whenever any device is increasing the speed, that time that device is known as nozzle. And whenever it is decreasing the speed, it is known as diffuser. In case of subsonic, your diffuser looks like this and nozzle looks like this. But in case of supersonic, this guy will be nozzle and this guy will be diffuser. I will explain again. You have subsonic, you have supersonic. In case of subsonic, I will make here. This is diffuser, this is nozzle. So your diffuser, diffuser will look like this and nozzle will look like this. In case of supersonic, this will be your diffuser and this will be your nozzle. Now, based on this, they have asked question in gate exam. They just gave the diagram and they just asked that. And you know what? That year I attempted them wrong. See, I attempted them wrong after knowing everything very, very clearly, because in exam hall, what more matters? How fresh you are. You know, whenever gate exam comes, I don't know why I don't sleep for 72, 2-3 days I will not sleep. Like full burden, because at the same time I have to take care of students, I have to take care of my own studies, everything, and I will not be getting proper sleep. My head will be paining, I will be paining. I will drink Red Bull or something, and I'll take and write exam to achieve more caffeine, and then everything, I lose my marks. But this year, anyway, I will try to be in top 10 somehow. Okay, guys, but actually, see, I don't want to join IIT. Joining IIT is not my dream. My dream is to open an aerospace company, and my aerospace company name will be Punk Aerospace. So Punk Aerospace is a very good name. I took so much time to think about this name. So guys, what do you say? Punk Aerospace is good name or not? Right? Because there can be some students from South, right? Prachi, Pavitra, you are from South India, right? Actually, punk means feather. You know, we have birds and those birds are having feathers, right? So that we say as punk. So actually, punk is the first thing which makes us to fly. So I am planning within 12 years, I'll be having my first rocket in lower orbit. So for that, I am arranging people, I am arranging money, capital, everything to make our first rocket. And I'm working on them separately. So in future, even I will be having, need of you guys, because I know that you guys will be also interested to work related to aerospace facts and everything. And don't worry, whenever it will happen, you will be get paid for everything. Okay, so thank you. Now you see, we are going to understand how continuity equation will come into mathematical picture. So either we talk about this part, that is a nozzle, or we talk about this part. Whatever mass will enter here, it will be entering every second. So whenever mass is entering every second, we say them as m dot, means it is not kg anymore. It is kg entering per second. So m dot is a symbol for mass flow rate. And m is a symbol for just mass. So we don't have to bother about mass. We have to bother about mass flow rate. So suppose we have a duct and mass flow rate is m dot. So you can say m1. So at the outlet, it should again be m1. But because this section you are considering as 1 and this section you are considering as 2, so give the symbol 2. And mass is nothing but density into volume. And wait, I have done something wrong. This I have to delete. Okay. Mass is nothing but density into volume. Density you leave as it is. Now what is volume? When something is flowing, then it will flow through some area. And it will be having some velocity. So when you multiply area with velocity, then you get volume flow rate, because velocity is nothing but length covered per second. So area into length will give you volume, and here you have per second, so that per second will be available there. So when you multiply area with length, you get volume, but when you multiply area with velocity, velocity is nothing but length per second. So this guy converts into volume, and per second will be there. So this will be volume per second. So if you are multiplying volume with density, you are getting mass. But if you will multiply volume per second, then you will get mass per second. That is called as mass flow rate. So this mass flow rate you can break as density into area into velocity. So m dot is equal to rho a v. But because we have two section, at this section you have different area and different velocity. So if you want to find out m1 at inlet, you put 1 here. If you want to find at outlet, you put 2 here. So here m1 you can write as rho A1 V1. A1 means this inlet area. Here you have M2. You can write as rho A2 V2. I am not changing rho here. Why? Why I am not writing rho 1 and rho 2? Because if you will rho 1, if you will write rho 1 and rho 2, it means you are considering that density is being changed. And if density is being changed, it means you are considering that this fluid is compressible. So we are considering incompressible. In the beginning itself, I should tell you, now I am telling, because point to point we are growing. So what happened? Everyone is available? Yeah. So now in the beginning itself, we have considered incompressible flow. It means rho 1 and rho 2, they are equal. Whatever density is available at this, same density we have at this. So to maintain same density means same gap, those people leave quickly. Okay. So because mass flow rate here and mass flow rate here has to be same to maintain the continuity. So equate both the equations. So you'll be having rho A1 V1 is equal to rho A2 V2. Some teachers can write rho 1 rho 2 and then later they can cancel rho 1 rho 2. No problem. So A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. This equation is popularly known as equation of continuity. So this was my attempt to explain equation of continuity. Equation of continuity is highly important for GATE exam, because they ask every year one question based on this. Now, you understand? You know, in childhood, if any one of you belong to a village, then you guys might be knowing this lamp, what I'm going to draw, lamp, L-A-M-P, lamp. At the bottom, we'll be having some kerosene oil, and then here we'll be having some flame burner or something that will go like this, and here we'll be having stand. In this stand we fix some kind of this glass will be like this, something like this. So continuity equation works here. By using continuity equation only, company is making this kind of design. What is the secret behind this kind of design? You see, here we'll be having holes, because from this hole only oxygen means air will enter, and this air will help this flame to burn. Whatever kerosene will be coming from, there will be one cloth here, attached cloth, that will suck the kerosene from the bottom. So kerosene will be loaded here, and some button will be here, and we can open and close and put kerosene. Okay, so kerosene will go here and will catch the fire. After that, whatever oxygen is coming from the atmosphere, that oxygen will help to burn this. Once, so you see, we got three types of area here. One area here, one area here, and one area here. This area you can consider as 2 meter square. This area you can consider as some 50 meter square, just some random data. And this area you can consider some 10 meter square, third one. You analyze A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Just now we have derived, known as continuity equation. You see, suppose here, this guy is entering, gases are entering very slowly. So give some velocity. Suppose they are entering with 2 meter per second. Why do we have this design here? We have this design because वॉट एवर गैसेज आर बींग बर्नड दे शुड लीव वेरी क्विकली बिकॉज दे आर नो मोर फ्रेश एयर दे आर लोडेड विथ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड सो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज नॉट हेल्पफुल फॉर बर्निंग सो वी हैव टू इजेक्ट देम दैट्स वाई वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग नोजल टाइप ऑफ शेप हियर दैट वॉट एवर गैसेज आर देयर दे शुड क्विकली गो देयर एंड हियर वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द एरिया सो यू नो दैट वेन एवर यू इंक्रीज द एरिया फ्लूड विल बी स्लो डाउन सो वाई आर वी इंक्रीजिंग द एरिया हियर बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट दीज कमिंग गैसेज टू स्टे हियर बिकॉज देन ओनली lot of oxygen will stay available for the burning purpose. If here itself you provide the nozzle, then whatever air will enter, this will go quickly outside. So this science, by using this sign, we design this kind of lamp. So this part over, and now we are going to discuss Bernoulli equation. Just now we have finished continuity equation. Now we are discussing Bernoulli equation. And in Bernoulli equation, P naught is equal to P static plus P dynamic. In yesterday class, we have discussed. Poonam, you are new today. So I think I will give you a separate class for 15-20 minutes for this. And I will explain you what is static pressure, what is dynamic pressure. So in Bernoulli equation, total pressure is P naught, which is nothing but the sum of static pressure and dynamic pressure. So static pressure, we don't have any specific formula. But for dynamic pressure, we have a formula. So P naught total pressure is equal to PS static pressure plus half rho V square. This is a formula for dynamic pressure. Now, this equation gives you idea that when velocity will increase, your dynamic pressure will increase. Then your static pressure will decrease. But total pressure will be same. No change. If your velocity will decrease, then dynamic pressure will decrease. Static pressure will increase, but again total pressure will be same, no change. So Bernoulli equation gives you variation of pressure Bernoulli equation gives you idea that how pressure varies with respect to velocity. I mean, if velocity will increase or decrease, how the pressure will change. Which pressure? Is static pressure. And continuity equation says, how do we maintain our area by need of velocity? What kind of velocity we want at the outlet? In that ratio, we design our area. So, area and velocity changes. Which equation governs them? Continuity equation. And Bernoulli equation governs the variation of pressure with respect to velocity. So, PV, AV. So, PV goes for Bernoulli equation, AV goes for continuity equation. Now, based on these two only, we have all these pipes where we measure total pressure, where we measure static pressure, dynamic pressure, all blah blah things. So we have probes, right? Static probes, static tube, pitot static tube, all those things in aerodynamics we will discuss. So that's why I'm building up the basic concept. Okay guys, so we'll start our class today. My throat is somewhat tired now. And so last 5 minute session from your doubts. So guys, you guys ask any doubt from whatever you have, make a note, or you have any circled doubt in your notebook, you can ask them in last 5 minutes. So we'll start with Tirthraj. Tirthraj, do you have any doubt? Yeah. Okay. Let me clear that also. Very good. You have taken that name, but I will take that name in propulsion. But see, convergent is just a designing name. If you are saying converge, it means you have to expand that. If you are saying diverge, this is diverge and this is converge. So it is a design criteria. I mean, designing name like lengthy, shorter, heighted. Okay. Like this is a kind of designing name. Today you have understood that this diverging curve will always not be diffuser. It can be nozzle also. Okay. So diverging duct or converging duct will not decide they are nozzle or diffuser. What kind of flow is that? Subsonic flow or supersonic flow? Okay. Any other doubt, Tirthraj? Okay. Then Ruchika, any doubt? Pavitra, any doubt? Prachi, any doubt? Poonam, any doubt? Okay, great. Then fine, we'll stop class today. And I have given some 3 or 4 work. Today you have very small work, so don't miss that homework. You finish that. And I will give some numericals. I will send them on WhatsApp. You have to solve them. Actually, whatever I have taught, they are the key points in GATE exam. Every topic they have asked the questions. So in next coming classes, we will solve all the questions. Don't worry about previous question papers. And now I will send you some homeworks. Some 5 to 7 questions will be there. You have to practice them and get the right answer. And we'll match in tomorrow class. And Poonam, I'll give you separate class for this static dynamic pressure. So that will be a session of some 15 minutes. Yes, if anyone wants to join that same class what I have taught yesterday, they can join. We will decide a timing with Poonam. Fine. Then, okay. Then we can stop. Okay. Then we can stop, guys. Okay, then. See you by tomorrow. Same time, 6 o'clock. Don't be late. Not even single second. Okay. Sharp 6. Okay. See you. Bye.